But by the intervention of consumer protection, which I got to know from some friends, who reassured me that the organization is under a new management, at, almost even saying that the new leadership could be likened to another Dora Akwili, I was interested, and that's how I came to this secretariat, and I was given almost like a warm reception. I was highly impressed by the attitude of staff, and I was asked to write my account, my story, and that was how they intervened. And they were able to get me another laptop. Okay. Otherwise, I would have lost my money. I would have lost the laptop. But here I am today. I have a new laptop, courtesy of the consumer protection. Okay.
It's about a Toyota vehicle, a brand new vehicle bought from Elizadi, Nigeria Limited. So it started developing faults, like between 1,000 to 5,000 kilometers. Whenever I want to negotiate corner, it just goes off. Wow. So when I came back, I went to them. It was under warranty, quite okay. So I went to them three times. So the fourth time I just came to CPC.
Okay.
So they mediated between us, and it was sorted out. So the fault continued again. So I didn't come back to CPC. I went to them for four, five, six times. So the seventh time I just came to CPC and pleaded with them that they should just replace the vehicle. They mediated between us. So they agreed that they will repair it. They will change the whole component, AC component.
And was that done?
It was done. And everything was sorted out. It hasn't given me fault again.
It was a wheat product which we bought.
Okay.
My wife bought the wheat product. It was on Thursday. So on getting to the house, she opened the wheat product and she discovered that some weevil inside the wheat. So, and it was getting late then. So we have to return the wheat the next day, which was Friday. Then. So when we get to the shelf, the woman refused to collect the wheat back.
Mm-hmm.
I said, okay, can we get another bag? Let me add something on top.
Okay.
Because of we have opened the bag already. She said no. That worse come to worse, we can go to the police. That Nigeria has no law.
No law.
So okay. That singular statement provoked me. I said, okay, don't worry. I know the appropriate place I will go. That you know that Nigeria has law. So on Monday, I have to rush down to CPC office.
Okay.
So I'm getting to CPC office and I narrated my story to them. The next day, the husband has to come to CPC and paid my money to CPC people. That's how I was narrated from the whole thing. Then the case goes to CPC and the wheat people, the manufacturer or the people that are selling the wheat or whatever.
Okay.
So that's how I got my
money and your...
Yeah.
Okay.
In summary, the problem was that of a developer building a house for us for 4.8 million, which you have to pay a third upfront, which we did pay. And the house was badly built in terms of poor materials, in terms of poor workmanship, in terms of poor documentation. Talking of RFO, building plan and all that, they were not properly obtained. The option was that we should go to court or look for alternative dispute resolution. The Consumer Protection Council came in handy, and we went there, we reported the matter to them. They summoned the two sides after exchange of documents and papers and write-ups, and they now called us for mediation. Finally, through the mediation process, they were able to subtle force, to get the developer to refund our money and take back the house from us.
We hope you have been greatly encouraged by the experience of the few consumers we can take on this episode. Rest assured that CPC will always be there for you, particularly in 2016.
Well, to consumers out there, let me first appreciate all those who have keyed into our new, renewed, aggressive consumer sensitization and have complained to us about various issues that they have with regards to the product or service that they have paid for. I want to appreciate you because in the year 2015, we have witnessed increased complaints in the council, which is reflective of the assertiveness of consumers away from where it used to be in the past. Let me also thank you all consumers who have sent us appreciations for resolve of your complaints in one way or the other. We have received numerous heartwarming letters expressing satisfaction in all that we have done to the consumers. So I want to appreciate those sets of consumers. But I'd like to tell everyone there to say that as consumer, you remain the king and the queen in the marketplace. Without you and without the use of your money, there is no business. Therefore, do not take no for an answer when you complain at the first point of your transaction. Continue to complain, don't grumble. And we at the Consumer Protection Council will remain resolute to ensure that you are not shortchanged in any way whatsoever. And as we enter into the 2016, I want to wish all of you a happy new year and a prosperous one. Keep your money stretching. Don't grumble. Complain. Thank you very much.
Hope you have enjoyed this program. Remember, as a consumer, you are the king of the consumer world, because without you, the service providers are out of business. Don't hesitate to come to CPC whenever you feel your rights have been breached. Our contact details are being displayed on your screen. We have 8 offices across the nation. I am Florence Abebe, your anchor. Have a good evening.